हे वेलकम बैक अगेन गाइस, संपत्ति वॉच एंड संपत साइंस एफएक्स यूट्यूब चैनल। एंड इफ यू आर फर्स्ट टाइम टू दिस चैनल गाइस, माय स्मॉल रिक्वेस्ट इज टू सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल। यू आर वाचिंग प्लेंटी ऑफ वीडियोस बट यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइबिंग टू माय चैनल। प्लीज़ हिट दैट सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड ऑल्सो ऑल द बेल नोटिफिकेशन। एंड इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो गिव इट लाइक। एंड दिस इज द न्यू रॉम वीडियो ऑन दिस रेडमी नोट 7 प्रो। एंड दिस द सीपीयू थ्रॉटलिंग टेस्ट इन दिस रॉम। एज यू कैन सी इट्स थ्रॉटल लिटिल बिट बट डेफिनेटली इट्स होल्डिंग अप टू दैट 80%। इट्स नॉट गिविंग अप, इट्स रियली गुड इन दैट केस। बट स्टिल इन द प्रीवियस रॉम्स इट वॉज फुल अप टू 100%, बट हियर इट्स लिटिल बिट थ्रॉटलिंग। बट एनी हाउ स्टिल इट्स बेटर कंपेयर टू other ROMs. It's a 112 build initial build ROM, so that this might be problem with initial build, but in the upcoming builds it might get fixed. And here I will stop this CPU throttling test. And as you can see, this is the STYX project version 2.2 alpha October 5th 2021 security patch with this is the kernel used here, that is 4.14.190 Vertigo version 2.1, and this is the latest build of October 20, and this is the 112 logo, the Easter egg, whatever you call. If you swipe like this, it will show this 112 logo. This is the 112 based one, like STYX alpha 2.0 ROM and CPU throttling test. I already shown the Geekbench scores are also impressive in this ROM. The single score is near to 500, which is really good, and the multi score is good, 14 14, which is really good. It takes time to adjust some of the settings, but it's fine. And coming to DRM info, here you will get Wide1 L1 certification, which is also a good thing. And coming to safety and status, here it's get failed at the CTS profile match and basic integrity is failed, such that you need to flash manually the CTS profile match and then it get passed. That one thing you need to note down guys. And after using that, you can use any payment apps, and also the WhatsApp, everything will work fine after that CTS profile match. And here something like Google camera is pre-installed. You can make a video using this 4K. As you can see, this camera application looks like better. Let's see where to go into the settings. Is there any settings? Let me take a snap here. Okay, let me show you the volume panel. You get here this type of volume controls. Okay, it's quick enough to take the sample shots. As you can see, if I go into information, it is taking in high resolution. The pictures are very good. If you want, you can use any Gcam ports, or even the ANX camera ports are also be supported for this ROM. And coming to like this, in the settings you get all the basic settings, the Android 12 settings, the network and internet connection, DNS, everything is given. In the app settings you get that usual default app settings, you can change from here. And also assistant you can wake from here, screen time, unused apps you can see here, and special app access, and those things are given. In the notification settings you get app notification, you can directly disable the notification of certain apps from here. And even the conversations you can check out. Bubbles feature is also given in this ROM, no need to worry on those things. Coming to battery life, the battery life is little bit, I need to test it out, but as of now I can show only this thing. Just recently I got this ROM update in Telegram group, I flashed this, so I had no time to test the battery life. If I can test it out later, I can update it out in the comment section below, you can check it out later. And this how you get all the battery manager settings here. It's enabled. And battery saver settings, extreme battery saver is not available here for some reason, and that's how the battery settings. In the sound settings you get all these settings, and in the display settings you get adaptive brightness. I will turn off this light once. Let's see if the adaptive brightness is works fine. as you can see, it's working fine. Again, the brightness is increased. The auto brightness sensor is also working fine in this ROM. No problem in this ROM after using in this Redmi Note 7 Pro. And dark theme, let's enable that. As you can see, it's in pitch black conditions. You get like this, and this is a quick settings panel. You get little bit of options here. You can drag them to use on your smartphone. And power button, you can toggle these settings from here. Also, in the settings panel, this looks like this, the dark theme. Nothing new here, but that's what it is. The font size and night light feature is also given. Colors also you can choose, natural, boost, adaptive, but I don't see any major difference if I change from there. Double tap anywhere on the screen to wake the device. No tap to screen to close, but anyhow, that is there in this ROM. And wallpaper settings, you get only few wallpapers here, nothing more, but app grid style you can change from here. The wallpapers are limited thing. And the security settings, you get screen lock, fingerprint unlock. I'll show you. I'll add you here, as you can see. And no face unlock, since it's an Android 12 and this Pixel type, Pixel Experience type ROM. You get smart lock here, but no app lock also. You have to use the third party applications to get those options. Let me check out the fingerprint unlock. Just tap unlock, it takes a second. It's not quickest, but anyhow, it's working fine. It takes time to check this settings, and location settings are also working fine. No problem here. You can see what all the applications using the location app. You can check it out. Password and accounts and system settings, you get here. Gesture settings, no gesture bar length adjustment. You will get like this small gesture. Do note these things, and you can go back to traditional three button navigation from here. Those things are working fine. I hope I have explained everything here in this ROM. And BGMI also I installed here. You can use GFX tool. By using that, you can play HD, Extreme, and even Smooth and Extreme is recommended settings. Without that, let's open what are the settings you get in this ROM. And coming to graphic settings, as you can see, as I said, it gets only Smooth Plus, Ultra, and HD base. Hey, if you want, you can use GFX tool to play in Smooth Plus, Extreme, which is going to be better in my experience. And coming to like call, this call recording or anything like that, let's see. Direct video call feature is given in this ROM. And coming to call recording feature, we don't get, I guess. Yes, we don't get that. And recently just I checked, this ROM is available for Violet, and I'll be flashing this out after this ROM testing for 2 more hours. And do comment down, guys, how is the experience with this ROM. And also I'll be sharing this ROM tomorrow morning. After flashing, I will test it out and I'll be showing out this ROM video tomorrow morning. So subscribe to my channel. You will be getting similar kind of videos in my channel. And let's see the, and this is the speed test in this ROM, STYX Alpha 2.0 on this Redmi Note 7 Pro. And it's pulling up to 90 Mbps, 91, which is really good. I have like 100 Mbps plan in JioFiber. And let's also test with mobile internet connection how much it will pull up to. And I am not getting any LTE plus here. It's not about the ROM, it's about the SIM network. But anyhow, I want to explain it out. Explained. And mobile internet is connected. And as you can see, it takes a little bit of time to adjust, but anyhow, it have done. And that's all, guys, in this video. I hope I have explained everything. The battery life, the charging time is also be similar with 10 watt charger. I don't use any fast charger in this ROM or in this smartphone particularly. And using wired earphones also, the output was good. And that's all guys in this video. I hope I have explained everything, and thank you for watching. See you in another interesting video. Until that, keep smiling. Bye bye for